How do you know if a chemical is hazardous? The first place to look is the label on the container. Labels may look a little different depending on the company, but they all have to follow the same basic rules. Each label must include clear, standardized information that tells you exactly what hazards the chemical presents. Chemical manufacturers, importers, and distributors are responsible for making sure that every container of hazardous chemicals leaving their workplace is properly labeled, tagged, or marked. These labels must be legible in English and clearly visible on the container. It's then the employer's job to ensure that those labels aren't removed or defaced when the chemicals arrive. While labels must be in English, employers may include information in other languages to accommodate non-English speaking workers, provided the English information is also present. In some cases, other types of warnings may be used as long as they effectively communicate the necessary information, which must be readily available in the work area throughout each shift. Examples include placards, process sheets, batch tickets, or written operating procedures. If a chemical is transferred from its original container into a portable one, that portable container needs to be labeled too, unless it's only being used by the employee transferring it and only for immediate use. For instance, if there is an oil spill in a walkway, an employee could fill a smaller unlabeled bottle of degreaser to clean up the spill immediately. But if the container is left unattended, it must be labeled. Whenever new hazard information becomes available, manufacturers, importers, distributors, and employers have 6 months to update the labels and make sure any containers shipped after that time include the new details. OSHA has also added flexibility for bulk shipments and packages released for shipment, ensuring practical implementation without compromising safety. Every label is required to include the product identifier, which is the unique name or number used to identify the chemical, ensuring consistency between the label and the safety data sheet. A signal word such as danger for more severe hazards or warning for less severe hazards. Hazard and precautionary statements, pictograms. Supplier identification, which includes name, address, and phone number of the chemical manufacturer or importer, providing a point of contact for further information. For small containers, 100 milliliters or less, there are special provisions allowing reduced information on the container itself as long as the full label is present on the outer package. Now let's take a quick look at how this information shows up on a real label. Right away, you'll spot the hazard pictograms. These symbols make it easy to see that the chemical poses both health risks and is flammable. The signal word, in this case, danger, is prominently displayed, letting you know this is a high-risk substance. Next is the hazard statement, which gives more specific details. For example, highly flammable liquid and vapor may cause liver and kidney damage. The label also includes precautionary statements with guidelines for safe handling. Here, it advises to keep the container tightly closed, store in a cool, well-ventilated place, and only use non-sparking tools and explosion-proof electrical equipment. Additional recommendations include grounding and bonding the container and equipment and protecting against static discharge. There's also information on first aid. For instance, the label might advise to call a poison center if exposed and include detailed steps like remove contaminated clothing immediately and rinse skin with water. Finally, you'll see the product identifier, which gives the chemical's name and the supplier identification so you know who to contact in case of an emergency. Remember, the label doesn't provide every detail on how to handle the chemical safely. It's meant to give you a quick overview of the risks and basic safety measures. For full details, including proper handling and emergency procedures, always refer to the safety data sheet. In addition to OSHA's hazard labels, you may also see NFPA, National Fire Protection Association, and DOT, Department of Transportation, labels on hazardous materials. The NFPA 704 label is a diamond-shaped sign used primarily for emergency response. It has four color-coded quadrants, blue, red, yellow, and white. The blue, red, and yellow quadrants include a scale rating the materials from 0 to 4, with 0 meaning minimal hazard and 4 indicating a severe hazard. The last quadrant is white, which includes 3 codes for specific hazards. Blue denotes a health hazard. This rates the potential health effects. Examples would be peanut oil as a 0 and hydrogen cyanide as a 4. Red denotes a flammability hazard. This measures how easily the material ignites. Examples would be water as a 0 and propane gas as a 4. Yellow denotes an instability hazard. This shows the material's tendency to react dangerously. Examples would be helium as a 0 and trinitrotoluene or TNT as a 4. White is used for special hazard codes. This is used for specific hazard symbols or notations, such as OX indicates an oxidizer, a chemical such as ammonium nitrate that can greatly increase the rate of combustion or sustain a fire without an external oxygen source. W with a strike-through signifies a substance such as potassium that reacts dangerously with water. SA denotes a simple asphyxiant gas such as nitrogen or helium which can displace oxygen in the air. NFPA labels are typically placed on buildings, storage tanks, or fixed containers to help first responders quickly assess the hazards of a chemical. Finally, let's talk about DOT hazard labels. The Department of Transportation uses specific pictograms on hazardous material shipments. These DOT labels, 1, use different background colors based on hazard class. A few examples are red for flammable materials, orange for explosives, yellow for oxidizers, green for non-flammable gases, and blue for substances dangerous when wet. Note that this is not an exhaustive list. 2, indicate transport restrictions and emergency handling requirements, ensuring that handlers and emergency responders are aware of the necessary precautions. 3, they must be placed on all bulk shipments of hazardous chemicals, including drums, tankers, and rail cars, as well as on non-bulk packages containing hazardous materials. One last thing. If a container is already labeled with a DOT pictogram for shipping, you won't need to add the same OSHA pictogram on top of it for the same hazard. This approach prevents redundancy and ensures clear hazard communication. For more detailed information on DOT hazard classifications and labeling requirements, you can refer to DOT Chart 17. This comprehensive guide provides visual representations and specific guidelines for each hazard class, serving as an essential resource for shippers, carriers, and emergency responders.